And the cockpit, when you get inside, is an incredible view here. This is much more going to be customer focused from a retail aspect. You can see the Apple CarPlay icons, you can see the music icons.
The Flow is our first SmartWheel powered EV.
What if you need an IndiGo now? There is an IndiGo Dash. Guys, you join me for the coolest and most exciting thing I have seen the entire week here at ACT Expo, and that is the Flow Cargo and the Flow Ride electric vehicle. These are the most futuristic and cool EVs that I have seen during the entire show. There's a lot of things here that we've seen in past expos, but this is a first, and just announced today is a partnership with my 9-to-5 FedEx for the Flow Cargo. FedEx is actually invested in IndiGo, and so it's exciting to see my two worlds collide, where my 9-to-5 and my passions unite for some of the coolest things that you'll see in electric vehicle transportation. Let's walk through the different vehicles and what they do and what they're used for. This is cool stuff you don't want to miss. So the Flow Cargo is a courier van. It's got the sliding door like we're used to seeing with many others. They can of course upfit this with all the different shelves and things that we would see in other circumstances. It's got a really low deck, and this really comes into play when we go to the back. Take a look inside at just the dramatic amount of space that you gain. There are some rails here on the floor area, and there are rails here on the side to make it very flexible and to be able to upfit this in a lot of very unique ways that I'm super excited about. Now, these are still 2 years away from production, but just to see how they look and imagine a future where we have our couriers in these is extremely exciting for me. What's very unique about these is the way they do their motors. So these have motors on all four wheels, and the suspension is incredibly smooth. Let's go take a look at how the suspension works, and it's something that I think is gonna be really beneficial when we get to the Flow Ride passenger vehicle. This would be something that's gonna be available with autonomous driving. It's gonna use LiDAR and cameras, and this will be used for things like rideshare services or shuttle vans. We use a lot of shuttle vans, for example, at the Oakland Hub, where we would take pilots and crew from their hotels to the airport. So we can see a lot of uses for these types of EVs. Fred Smith was personally involved with supporting and funding and partnering with this company. So IndiGo is doing some incredible things that I'm excited to see come to real life in the next couple of years. Let's check out the suspension.
Our SmartWheels technology, with over 100 patents, uniquely integrates powerful direct drive propulsion with road sensing active suspension into each motor. Each wheel uses sensors that feed back to our robotics vehicle software to automatically adjust to bumps, potholes, and turns for an exceptionally smooth and safe ride. The Flow is our first SmartWheel powered EV. It is remarkably efficient, with 180 cubic feet of space, which is 30% more space than other vehicles in its weight class.
So let's talk about the driver's seat for this. When you open these doors, there are these cool suicide doors, and then it's got the center driver position. This is similar to what we've seen with the Tesla Semi. It's got this very unique steering wheel situation. And then the cockpit, when you get inside, is an incredible view here. So you've got something very unique that we're not sure if we're gonna see this be integrated. Again, it's 2 years away, so we'll see what regulation looks like. But you can see that your rear view mirrors are camera. There are not physical rear view mirrors there on the sides. This may or may not make it into production with solely having the camera-based rear view mirrors. The cameras will be here either way, but they may have to have physical mirrors as well. But still 2 years away means they've got time to help influence the regulations on this. Up here, something that we wish we could see with the Cybertruck, an actual rear view mirror camera. So that's super cool. And then down here, you've got your driver display. This is gonna show you your state of charge. This is gonna show you your miles per hour and your range. You can see here at 95% state of charge, we're looking at 220 miles of range. Of course, we know with EVs, this varies for a number of different reasons. They are targeting about 200 miles of range on these. And then down here, you've got some more data and some more controls for the different things inside the vehicle. So really futuristic view. Again, just one of the coolest things I have seen at the show. Here you've got your steering wheel and you've got your different controls for horn, airbag, different things for lane centering
And ultimately, there's going to be some aspect of automation and autonomous driving with this in the future as well. So lots of really exciting things when we're talking about the future of courier vans and services. A ton of use cases for a vehicle like this. And you can see behind me here, just again, that enormous amount of space that we saw before. Let's take a look at the passenger van. This again is the flow that's meant for courier services and delivery, but that one is gonna be the flow rider, which is made for ride share, or again, that type of transportation. And that has a unique aspect to it that I really appreciate from a mobility side. Let's take a look over there at that. So one of the very unique aspects of these vans is the way that they have the low cargo deck. And that's great, of course, for the delivery van, but what's super cool about the passenger van, the Flow Rider, is that this will actually be ADA accessible, to where they have a ramp that will go on here, and you can actually put a wheelchair in the back, and you've got these rails here that, in this case, have a seated position, but these rails can also accommodate a wheelchair that can be locked in place safely. So there's a number of accessibility couriers and van services and transportation that this is going to be an incredible value for, and I've never seen really an EV version of this type of like paratransit potential. So being able to see this thought through from this perspective of mobility and wheelchair accessibility and the low ramps and those types of things is super encouraging from any kind of EV company, and definitely think that this is one of those aspects that's unique to the Flow Rider. As we swing back around here to the passenger area, this is currently set up with the dual captain's chairs. There's also, of course, a bench seat function, so you could have that configuration if you prefer. As we swing around to the cockpit area, you're gonna see that same center seated position with the very similar screens that we saw before. So let's take a look at how that looks for the Flow Rider. Here you can see this is much more going to be customer focused from a retail aspect. You can see the Apple CarPlay icons, you can see the music icons, still have your camera side mirrors, and still have the rear view mirror that's a camera as well. But you can see this is much more of a layout design for the screens that is gonna be centered around a passenger function rather than a cargo function. Here you can see like the different motors and the different flow of energy that's gonna be here. So that's really cool to see. Again, you can see the different gauges for your miles per hour and your range and all that kind of stuff, but you don't have the more industrial functions down here that we saw in the cargo van. So steering wheel, very similar with your lane centering and your different functions that you're used to seeing on the wheel, just a different layout from a UI perspective, as you would expect with something that's meant for riders. So super fun, a lot still to come here. Again, 2 years still before we see this go public. For now, I'm encouraged by what we're seeing here. One more really unique aspect that differentiates the Flow Rider from the Flow Cargo is the roof. So here you've got a full glass panoramic roof, and over here on this side, it's a solid roof. But what they've done that's super cool when you peek inside is they have lighting here, which of course we know is a great, just in terms of being able to see and for visibility here for the driver that's doing the cargo deliveries. This would also be great for like a plumber or an electrician or anybody in the trades. So again, having this illuminated area for your tools or for your boxes or whatever that might be is a great thought out design feature that I think is really cool and that I certainly appreciate. So of course, one of the questions everybody's gonna want to know is, how much are these incredible futuristic EVs? Right now they are targeting a price point of $50,000. That is before any incentives. So cross our fingers that those stick around politically. But again, a very reasonable entry level price point for these. And I am encouraged to see if they are able to hit that. Again, 2 years is a long time in the EV space. And although these are production intent and these are generally going to be what the target platform is going to look like, we all know that a lot can change in 2 years, but $50,000 is a great targeted price for these, especially in the fleet space. And I think there's gonna be a definite market for it. But what if you cannot wait for 2 years? What if you need an IndiGo now? There is an IndiGo Dash. This is made in South Korea. It's going to be imported towards the end of the year. The price point is right around $27,000, again, before incentives. That is an incredible value. This does not have the four motor controls like the other two do, and it doesn't have the suspension, but it is a very economical solution, especially for in-city courier deliveries. This could be things like flower shops, again, catering, auto parts stores, any number of things they need to zip in and out of a city, like where I'm from in San Francisco, New York, any of those places where really you need to get in and out, park quickly, make your deliveries. Plenty of functions also for whether it's delivering parts and supplies or currying people from place to place. There's a lot of cool things about the dash that, just like its name, make for a quick, easy solution in the EV space. So anytime you can talk about something coming in with a price point of $27,000, that is an incredibly exciting number to hear, especially if you can get the incentive on top of that. So the dash is gonna be a bit more of your contemporary experience that you're used to. We've got the side-by-side seats. We've got the kind of traditional dash layout. This is gonna give you 90 cubic feet of cargo. It's gonna still be able to be used as a shuttle van for a couple passengers as well. There's a number of different ways you can customize this. And again, the price point is something that you just can't beat with the dash. When you're talking about $27,000, you just can't go wrong for this as an entry-level vehicle. So I just love seeing these kind of creative solutions that get people into the EV market. And you can see you got the cargo space here. You've got the back seats that can be taken out or folded. And then over here, you got your front driver experience. So let's swing back around to this side and take one more look from the passenger side. And again, much more of that traditional look. Again, these are gonna come out of South Korea here by the end of the year. So lots of exciting things at this booth. By far, the most fun I've had is visiting the IndiGo team. This is, without a question, the best thing at ACT Expo for me that is unique and different and really pushing the envelope of electric vehicle transportation, both in the fleet side as well as the transportation side for retail customers and for rideshare and that type of thing. So lots of great functions here. Hopefully you guys have learned something today. I know I've had a lot of fun over here at IndiGo. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like this kind of content. Leave your thoughts down below. Let me know what you think about these incredibly radical designs and the future of EV fleet transportation. Thanks for joining. Don't forget to check in for Turn Down for Watt, the podcast. And of course, thank you for joining us at Bow Family EV. We'll see you on the next one.